practice beforehand.
Smoke bombs.
Smoke bombs, where?
The part, the trick section. They should have a smoke bomb.
Okay, so I wanted to record this now whilst it's still fresh in my mind, one to help me remember, but also to share with you guys. So I have just had a shamanic drumming and healing experience, which was really, really lovely. I love shamanic drumming, and I've always been drawn very much to shamanic sort of healing and experiences. So it was really lovely. It was about a 20 minute treatment. The vibrations caused by the drum, starting at the top of your body and then working it his way down your body, along the sides of your body, then up the back of your body, and then finishing around your head again. It was just a lovely experience, really relaxing. The vibrations like literally penetrate to your soul, they really do. You see them, you know, inside you, kind of stirring up the different cells of your body. So that was a lovely experience. And then whilst he's doing that, she is kind of scanning your energy, and then she sort of tries to heal areas that need healing, basically. So the really interesting thing was he picked up on some areas on this side, on my shoulder, and I've had issues with this shoulder that I spent a lot of money having treated through an osteopath. It's still not 100%, but she did a really good job on healing it, and he's picked up on problems there. He's also picked up on the fact that I have a really hard time accepting things that are given to me. So accepting praise, accepting gifts, accepting I'm worth something. So when people praise me or say something good or give me something, I feel like I have to, like I need to earn it, or I feel like I have to give back, or I feel like I need to offer them something, rather than just accepting and feeling that actually I deserve that, so that's okay. The other thing that came through from her was I have a lot of spirits waiting to work with me, and that I'm not following, that I should really be working in some kind of spiritual field, which again is something I've always been drawn to, but I just don't feel, I kind of normal life, I guess, gets in the way of what I really sometimes feel drawn to, which is this. And I feel at my happiest when I'm at places like this festival, where there's a lot of like-minded people, when I do forest school, when I had the hand fasting with my partner. Those sorts of experiences are very spiritual, and they're really lovely, and I feel like I'm doing what I meant to do, and I feel like I'm where I'm meant to be. Unfortunately, those experiences don't last very long, and then I'm back into the mundane everyday life. and ignoring what is actually something I should be doing for myself, fulfilling my needs rather than, I guess, fulfilling everybody else's needs and you know, caring for everybody else. So so I need to think seriously about that. I would really like to, you know, I did my crystal healing course and various other things, and I really would like to get more into that side of things, because that's where I feel drawn, and I've been ignoring it for a long time. So I need to do that. She also talked about, let me think, I'm trying to think, there was something else she said that really resonated with me. I mean, one of the things she did pick up on this real need for me to go into something spiritual, working in a spiritual way. And I mentioned that I've always felt in every house I've ever lived in and different places that I've gone, I can picture an image of a person. I've always felt it was like ghosts, like an image of a person who is in that place, and that, so convinced that I would see them with my eyes. And it's never the same person in the same place. And I don't go into a place expecting it. In fact, the house I live in now is the only place I haven't had that. And in fact, it's the only place that we've truly had some unusual experiences. And we talk about ghosts because ghosts take things and then gives them back randomly in really obvious places about 3 months later. And so now we all, including the children, say, "Mr. Ghosty, please can we have that back? Thank you very much. It was very funny." And we have this little joke. But to be honest with you, I'm actually... I never have an image of what ghosty looks like in this house, but I've had images in every house I've lived in that are so strong that I'm convinced I'm going to walk into a room and see that person. I feel that person's energy there. So maybe those are actually my spirit guides, kind of very present and trying to draw me into that way, and to pay more attention to it. And the thing that I was really, really pleasantly surprised to hear was that I definitely have a Native American background. Some way, somehow, which is probably why my interest in shamanic drumming and that kind of therapies and healing, and you know, I have an interest in that, and I'm drawn to stories about Native Americans. I love the art of Native America. So yeah, I think, and actually the Canadian Haida Indians, I'm really drawn to their artwork, and loves, you know, when I've been in Canada. We went to Capilano Suspension Bridge. I've been twice in my life, and both times I felt very at home, even on a scary bridge that is really high. There was a lot of native, you know, Haida Indians there, creating stuff and making stuff, and I just felt really at home. So that's a really lovely thing to be told. So yeah, I just wanted to record this really so that I have... a memory of it, something I can go back to before I forget and get home and forget what's been said to me. And I've sent Brendan off to go and get an ice cream. He's really not feeling it today, unfortunately. He usually likes a bit of Reiki healing and stuff, but he's just not feeling it. So I'm hoping he's okay. I was going to suggest the drumming, but he struggles. I mean, it could be the music that's causing a problem for him, because the drumming affects his stomach. So he could be that he's feeling the beat of the music a little bit too intensely. And it tends to make him feel a bit sick. So I've sent him off for ice cream while I record this. And I'm going to go back up now and go and have a nice ice cream with him and go and listen to some music.
Everywhere. Yeah, good. Oh, yeah, bye. Bye.
just filming away.
Hey, hey, hey. Yeah.